This has been a super requested video. I appreciate you guys tuning in. This is a what's in the bag golf video. Now, a lot of you guys might not be following my golf journey, but for me, golf has been one of the most important things in the last 2 years for me. While Morgan was gone, I would come here. This was my sanctuary. Not a bad place to be. I'm out here at Sand Hollow on the range. I've taken my game with the help of a lot of different coaches, from Richard Woodhouse, Dan Maravich, Coach Alex Riggs from Dubai, and I've actually gotten to go from about a 20 handicap down right now to about an 11. So this is my bag. We're gonna be going through it right now. First off, talking about the bag, it is an Ogio silencer bag. Ogio obviously makes great equipment. First things first, we'll start with the most important club, putter. If I could tell you guys, you beginners, one thing, I would say, start with putting, start with chipping, start with pitching, and you work your way out. I've read books from Harvey Pennick, Tiger Woods, How I Play Golf, Ben Hogan's book, read that. They all kind of reiterate the same thing. Start with learning how to putt, chip, pitch. I wish I would have done that. I went straight for, obviously, we all want to hit the big stick a mile, but if you can get good with a putter, you're gonna save yourself. My putter is a Bettinardi. I really like what they do. Just with the milled face, that means there's no insert in here. This Bettinardi is a BB1. It's kind of their OG. It is a blade with that hosel neck. So the grip, the weight of the head, it's well balanced. For me, I play a 35-inch putter. For my wedges, I have my 50, a 54 that I use as my sand wedge, and then a 58. All of those are Callaway's Jaws Raw wedges with little Hobbs Cook stamped on there. That's one of the things I love. Shout out to Anthony over at Callaway. Wedges are one of those things when you want to get spin around the green with your pitching, with your chipping, very important clubs. Moving on, my irons that I play. These are Callaway X'd Forge CB. So they are forged. I started off, I went out to Callaway. I actually got fitted out there. They gave me a player's improvement set of irons, and then they gave me these as well. I'm still growing into these. They are a club that is a little bit harder to hit. I would not recommend these for a beginner. I'd recommend these for someone who's probably a single digit handicap. But I have my pitching through 4-iron. My 4-iron is a club that just recently in the last 3 months, I feel like that I'm hitting fairly well. It stayed in the bag for the most part, but those are my irons. I have a hybrid in the bag. I love this club. This is my 3-wood. It's set at 20 degree loft on there. Hybrids are, you know, they're one of those things that you see even a lot of pros hit hybrids. A lot of pros don't. You've seen them become more popular because they're supposed to be a little bit easier to hit than if I had like a 3-iron. Grip is probably the biggest thing as a beginner. I wish I would have worked on more. I heard it was important. I thought I was doing enough grip work. I'm telling you, you can't play really good golf until you have a good grip. Moving on, super excited for these next three clubs because I actually just got them. First one, Epix utility wood. And when I say I just got them, like I just hit this thing for the first time today. So we're gonna hit it a little bit more later on here. It's a utility wood. It's in between like my 3-wood or a 5-wood and a hybrid. A lot of times this replaces my 3-wood if I'm hitting off the deck, which means if I'm hitting off the turf, not hitting off a tee. I could still hit this pretty well off a tee as well. This is my carry 240 club. From there, depending on the conditions, it'll roll out a little bit. 19 degrees, my 3 at 20. This one is set at 19. I got this club because I had too big of a difference between my 3 hybrid and my 3 wood. So this kind of fits that need. Moving on from there, the Paradym triple diamond. This is such a sweet club. I've been wanting to hit this for a long time. Finally got it. Shout out to Callaway. You guys treat me well. This triple diamond 3 wood is absolutely, it looks great. Probably swing it right between 105 to 107. I like this to carry, ideally, if I'm hitting it well, 260-ish. It hits piss missiles is what it does. It's an absolute bomber. And now for the big stick, I have the brand new Paradym. Now I did not go with the triple diamond. I just went with the standard Paradym. I don't have it on a draw or fade bias. There's lots of different things, settings. You can get just so intense with all the different things you can do with your golf clubs, especially your driver. Right now I have it on a 9 degree loft. Loft is going to determine how high you're kind of hitting it. And then I can also mess around, set it more on a draw bias or a fade bias. This is set at 44.5 inches long. So it's a little bit smaller than you can get it. I just find that with a smaller shaft, I get a little bit more consistency hitting that middle of that club face. But this thing, absolutely loved hitting it today. I had the Rogue, really loved it. So I was kind of feeling like I didn't need a new driver. But then when I hit this, I just felt like the face with that carbon, with that jailbreak technology, I just loved the way it sounded. So Callaway, and look at the paint job. Look at it just glistening in that St. George sun. All right, guys, we have been through my bag, the clubs, the settings, what I'm hitting these days. I will say, if anything, golf has taught me patience. I'm a super competitive person, and I really wanted to get good quickly. That being said, you can't rush things. It's just about putting in the time, putting in the effort. I will say having a coach kind of helped me out to just speed up that process. And there's also some tools that some of these coaches recommended. I don't even know this company. It's a SKLZ Tempo Grip Trainer. So it's heavier. This is all weighted. What I like in it is this grip. It actually teaches you the correct grip on the golf club, and that's super important. So you go from this. I watched a lot of YouTube videos when I bought this. I was like, oh, I can actually feel that my right hand needed to get a little bit more on top of this left hand. And I also like swinging it at home. I don't hit things. I warm up before a round with it, like I said, because it's weighted. Once you have the grip, Lagshot swing trainers. This is a driver. They make them in different, you know, irons and things like that. This is a wobbly club, and what this teaches you is correct tempo. If you don't have good tempo when you swing this club, you're not gonna hit it. You wanna swing this without hitting balls at first, but then you can hit balls. You know, I've gone out to the range. My best driving days come after I've spent some time practicing with this. It kind of goes hand in hand with the grip. You don't want to grip it too tight, and you don't want to have all those muscles. Working out in the gym a lot, I tend to muscle everything. Golf is not one of those things you can do that. It starts with the grip, and then you have to learn how to have easy tempo, let it drop into the slot and hit. Definitely recommend those two things in terms of getting set up with just your swing. The next couple things, I have my iRange Sports. I actually use this in the gym for filming workouts and stuff as well. Your iPhone goes on this. I'm such a visual learner. I'll watch swings. I think I'm looking like Rory McIlroy. I'll go look at my swing and I look absolutely off. I would send off my videos to coaches. This really gets it set up so where when I practice, that iPhone on there shooting right through my hands. If you guys are into wanting to maximize your practice, film it, watch it back, compare your swing, you can start seeing the little things you do or don't do that need fixing. Next up, I'll actually talk about all of this Garmin equipment because it's pretty sweet. First thing I have, this watch. This watch is the Epix. And it is truly epic. I do everything from my fitness stuff, tracking heart rate, my workouts, steps, even my sleep, to then also golf course stuff. My score, it knows the GPS, it actually downloads the course, tells you how far you're out from the green. I also have a little mini launch monitor. So this is my Approach R10, and it's kind of like what a TrackMan does. I'm one of those people that likes to know every little nuance. So this is a way for me to, you know, not spend $30,000 on one of those expensive launch monitors. It's a little portable launch monitor that'll tell me my swing path, my swing speed, club path, club face, all of these awesome things that then they have an app on your phone that you download and you get all of the data there. So the other thing that I have from Garmin is my rangefinder. So this rangefinder, the Approach Z82, it's crazy. It's way different than any other rangefinder because it's almost like a digital download in the top. As I look through it, I see the entire hole. You know, if you've ever played golf and in the cart, they have a GPS system. It's kind of like that. It uses GPS. It knows the course you're on. It tells you where the bunkers are, where the hazards are. So it definitely helps your game out. Moving on from there, putting. Putting is super important. It's one of those things that you'll kind of like just, oh, I can putt. I've been to putt-putt. Having something where it actually teaches you how to line properly, this is that for me. I'll bring it out to the golf course and actually just putt on it before a round or just on its own. It's super nice. Richard Woodhouse and the Back to Basic Golf guys use this. Shoulder alignment, eye alignment. Gives you a club path there. Love this thing. When I do eventually make it to scratch, this thing's gonna be a big reason why. And then one of the things also I don't play or practice without, this company's called GrooveIt. It's basically boom, 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 has water inside. Get it on your club. You gotta take care of your tools. If you don't take care of your tools aren't gonna take care of you. Golf ball I play is a Titleist. I play, right now I play the left dash, the Pro V1X. Left dash specifically. Pro V1X is a super, super great ball itself. The left dash was for low spinning. As a newbie, you're gonna see that spin is a good thing to a certain point and then it's a bad thing. Right now I'm hitting these, but I'm thinking about going just back to the Pro V1X because to be honest, my spin now is getting too low, which is weird. as you can see, tons of equipment. Don't go out there and buy all of this stuff at once. This is the stuff that over the last 2.5 years I found has helped me with my game the most. I probably use at least weekly or every time I come out onto the course. If you guys have people that you wanna see me collab with, whether it's Good, Long Drive, Kyle Berkshire, Martin Bergmeier from Germany, Bryson DeChambeau. You know, if you're not into golf, if you just like going to the driving range, maybe you wanna get into golf, appreciate you guys watching this. Give it a thumbs up. If you're not subscribed to the channel yet, do so. We're gonna have so much more workout content coming soon. What I'm gonna be doing is uploading 4 workout videos a month, and then also I'm gonna be uploading a golf video probably once a month as bonus content. Basically, we're gonna be getting ready to get to scratch. The software I'm using right now is called Draw More Circles. I basically, when I play, I enter in all my shots. I get kind of geeked up about it. They have a software program that you can get on. You track your shots, it tells you where you need to be better at in comparison to a scratch golfer. It's been telling me, hey, driver, put it down, you're good there. Where I'm weak right now is putting, chipping, pitching. So I'm gonna try to do some collaborations with people that are good at those things, get me better. Guys, definitely check out Draw More Circles if you guys are into golf and looking to improve your handicap. Not being paid at all to promote it. It's just one of those things that I've used that I've absolutely loved it. I'm gonna link, you know, these products in the description. I get no kickback from any of them. I like these products. I use these products. You know, they've helped me out, and I shouldn't say they will definitely help you out, but I think that they will. If you guys, you know, like golf like me, it teaches you patience. It teaches you that, you know, sometimes in life you might hit a great shot. It takes a bad bounce. You got to stay cool, calm, and collected. And so that's why I love golf these days. And I appreciate you guys watching this video. We'll see you guys next time. Right now, I want to sink this putt. Uphill, breaking. Left to right. Hey, you know what? I'll take that. That's within 3 feet.